صلوا على الحبيب الله أمام محمد.
Please take note that the programs and other transmissions aired on Madini channel may contain clips of various occasions and audible editing.
صلوا على الحبيب الله أمام محمد
صلوا على الحبيب صلى الله تعالى على محمد. نية المؤمن خير من عمله. مسلمان کی نیت اس کے عمل سے بہتر ہے. اللہ عز وجل کی رضا پانے اور ثواب کمانے کی غرض سے سلسلہ دیکھنے سے پہلے اچھی اچھی نیتیں فرما لیجئے. اللہ کی رضا کی خاطر علم دین حاصل کروں گا, سیکھ کر دوسروں تک نیکی کی دعوت پہنچاؤں گا, خاص خاص باتیں لکھوں گا, اول تا آخر دیکھوں گا. صلو علی الحبیب صلی اللہ تعالی علی محمد.
الحمدللہ رب العالمین والصلاة والسلام علی سید المرسلین اما بعد فاعوذ باللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. الصلاة والسلام علیک یا رسول اللہ وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of the Madani channel, Alhamdulillah, there are many blessings and benefits in reciting durood upon the best of creation, the Holy Prophet Muhammad Mustafa Ahmad Mujtaba sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has stated that anyone who recites Durood Sharif upon me 3 times in the day and 3 times in the evening out of love and devotion for me, Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive the sins that person has committed that day and that night. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, the month of Rajab al-Murajab holds great blessings, especially for those people who do extra worship in this month, and especially for those people who fast in this month. My dear Islamic brothers, please listen to the following incident very carefully. There was once a pious woman who lived in Basra, and when the time of her death came close, she requested her son to bury her with the clothing that she used to wear when she used to worship in the month of Rajab. After she passed away, her son shrouded her in a different cloth and then he buried her. When he came home from the graveyard, he was shocked to see that the shroud, the kafan that he just buried his mother in, was right before him in his home. Now this person, the son, he was very shocked and he became agitated. So he tried to find the clothing that his mother asked to be buried with, which coincidentally was the clothes that she used to wear when she used to worship in the month of Rajab. But after looking everywhere, he couldn't find the cloth. The cloth had disappeared from the home. All of a sudden, he heard a voice from the unseen say that, "Take your shroud back. We've wrapped your mother up in the cloth that she wanted to be shrouded in. Those who fast in the month of Rajab, we do not keep them sad in their grave." Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, from this incident, we see that fasting in the month of Rajab and worshipping in the month of Rajab holds great blessings. And insha'Allah azza wa jal, such people will not be grieved and will not be sad in their graves. Hujjatul Islam Imam Muhammad Ghazali alayhi rahmatullah al-wali, writes in Mukashafatul Qulub that the word Rajab is derived from the word Tarjeeb. And this word Tarjeeb means to respect. And they further write that Rajab is from amongst those months which are very holy and which hold a lot of greatness. And this is a month that we should show great respect to. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, Rajab is also the name of a river in paradise. And the water in this river is whiter than milk, it is sweeter than honey, and it is colder than ice. And the only people who will be able to drink from this river will be those who fast in the month of Rajab. The pious elders and the saints of the past, rahimahumullah, have said that the word Rajab contains three letters: the letter Ra, the letter Jim, and the letter Ba. And they say that the letter Ra stands for Rahmat-e-Ilahi, the mercy of Allah Ta'ala. And the letter Jim stands for Jurm, a crime committed by a person. And the letter Ba stands for Bir, meaning to have a favor upon someone or to be beneficent towards someone. So we see that the letter Jim, meaning Jurm, meaning crime, is in between the letters Ra and the letter Ba. So it is as if though Allah Ta'ala is saying that those people, for those people in the month of Rajab, He has kept the crimes of such people between His mercy, His rahmat, and between His favors. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Allama Safuri rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says that Rajab is the month in which you plant the seed. Sha'ban al-Mu'azzam is the month of irrigation. It is the month in which you water the seed that you planted back in Rajab. And Ramazan al-Mubarak is the month in which you harvest your crops. Ramazan is the month in which you cut what you grew. So if you didn't plant the seed of worship in Rajab, and if you didn't moisten that seed with tears in Sha'ban, then how will you ever be able to cut the crops of Allah Ta'ala's mercy in Ramazan? Hazrat Sayyiduna Allama Safuri alayhi rahmah further states that Rajab purifies the body, Sha'ban purifies the heart, and Ramazan is for the purification of the soul. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has stated that Rajab is the month of Allah Azza wa Jal, and Sha'ban is my month, and Ramazan is the month of my ummah. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, from these few narrations we learn about the excellence of the month of Rajab al-Murajab. Now listen to another statement and hadith. Hazrat Sayyidina Abdullah bin Zubair radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that if someone solves a problem of his fellow Muslim, if someone relieves a trouble of his fellow Muslim in this month, believing that this month Rajab is the month of Allah Azza wa Jal, then as a reward for this, he will be granted such a vast mansion in paradise that the boundaries of this mansion will be as distant as the eyes can see. Subhanallah, my dear Islamic brothers. In this month, if we solve or relieve a problem of a Muslim, then look how great our reward is. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, there are 4 months which hold a lot of reverence. And they are very sacred and holy. Allah Ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, Surah At-Tawbah, verse number 36, translation of Kanzul Iman, undoubtedly The number of months with Allah Ta'ala is 12 in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Since the day He made the heavens and the earth, 4 of them are sacred. And this is the right religion. Therefore, do not wrong yourselves in the calculation of these months. Now, Hazrat Sayyidina Sadr al-Afazil Mawlana Muhammad Naimuddin Muradabadi alayhi rahma says that by the 4 months, by the 4 sacred months, it is referring to Dhul-Qa'da, Dhul-Hajj, Muharram and Rajab. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani Channel, in the days of ignorance, the Zamanai Jahiliyat, the Arabs would stop all the wars, they would stop all the battles and killings out of respect for these months. And with the advent of Islam, with the coming of Islam, the holiness of these months has greatly increased. So my dear Islamic brothers, we should try to show extra respect to these months. We should try to do extra worship in these months. And we should make extra efforts to stay away from sins in these respected months. My dear Islamic brothers, in these months, we should make extra effort to try and pray namaz with jama'at. We should try to make extra effort to recite the Holy Quran. We should make extra effort to gain the knowledge of deen. We should make extra effort to travel on the Madani qafilas of Dawat-e-Islami. We should try our very best to increase our amal and action upon the Madani inamat. My dear Islamic brothers, in general, we should try to increase our good deeds and stay away from all bad deeds. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, there is an incident which took place at the time of Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. There was a man who had been in love with a woman for a very long time. And one day, this man, he got a chance to fulfill his evil desires. And he managed to get hold of this woman. But when he looked around, he saw that the people were looking at the sky to see the new moon. He asked the woman, "Which moon, which month's new moon are these people looking at?" And the woman replied, "We are looking at the moon of the month of Rajab. Today is the first of Rajab." Now this man, he was a disbeliever. But when he heard the name Rajab, out of respect for this holy month, he moved away from this woman and saved himself from committing the evil sin of adultery. Allah Ta'ala ordered Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam to go and see this person. Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam went and met this man and told him about what Allah Azza wa Jalla had said and why he alayhi salam was here. When the man heard this, his heart was filled with light and he became a Muslim. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, look at the wonders of this holy month and how showing respect and honor to this month a disbeliever can be blessed with iman. Now imagine, if this is the mercy that descends upon a disbeliever, then what will be the level of blessings that will descend upon a Muslim? My dear Islamic brothers, we should try our utmost best to respect and revere this month by abstaining from sins. Now this is a month of Tawbah also. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated that the angel Hazrat Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam came to me and told me that on the first night of Rajab al-Murajab, when the new moon appears, Allah Ta'ala orders an angel to make an announcement. And the angel announces that everyone listen, the moon for the month of repentance, the moon for the month of Tawbah has appeared. There is good news for those who do Tawbah and repent in this month. My dear Islamic brothers, this is a month of Tawbah and this is a month in which the reward for the actions is doubled. My dear Islamic brothers, if anyone gives charity and spends in the way of Allah Ta'ala in this month, then Allah Azza wa Jal moves that person away from the hellfire. And the distance he has moved away is equivalent to the distance covered by a crow if it was to hatch from its egg, then leave its nest, and then start to fly, and continue flying until it grows old and dies. And my dear Islamic brothers, it is said that a crow lives for 500 years. So my dear Islamic brothers, make intention to spend in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal in this month. Be very charitable in this month. Give in the way of Allah Almighty in this month. InshaAllah Azza wa Jal, there is glad tidings and good news for such people. In a hadith pak, my dear Islamic brothers, it is mentioned that whoever on the 15th of Rajab recites a Surat Fatiha, recites the Alhamd Sharif 10 times without poking in between, then it is as if though he has given charity in gold, which is equivalent to all the land that there is on the face of the earth. Subhanallah. My dear Islamic brothers, it is so easy to earn good deeds in this month. Just recite Surat al-Fatiha 10 times in this month on the 15th of Rajab without talking in between. All brothers, make intention for this. In one narration, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said that whoever for the pleasure of Allah ta'ala keeps even one fast in the month of Rajab, he will enter paradise. Subhanallah. My dear Islamic brothers, this month holds many, many blessings. Sayyiduna Khalid bin Walid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that all the 8 doors of paradise are open for those people who fast on the 15th of Rajab, and they can enter through whichever they want. Subhanallah. In another narration, my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, the master of the universe, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, has said that the month of Rajab is from amongst the sacred months. Its days are written in the 6th sky. If someone keeps a fast in the Rajab and fulfills it with piety, then that fast and that day, ask Allah Azza wa Jal for that person's forgiveness. And they say, oh Allah Azza wa Jal, forgive this person. And if that person keeps the fast without piety, without parahezgari, then that fast and that day, do not ask Allah Ta'ala for the forgiveness of that person. Instead, they say to the person that your nafs has deceived you. My dear Islamic brothers, in another hadith pak, it is stated that whoever keeps a fast on the 1st of Rajab, it is as if though he has fasted for the whole month. And if someone fasts for 7 days, the 7 doors of hell are closed for him. And if someone fasts for 8 days, then the 8 doors of paradise are open for him. And whoever fasts for 10 days, all his sins shall be changed into good deeds. And whoever fasts for 18 days, an unseen voice says that Allah Ta'ala has forgiven all your sins. Now for the remainder of your life, do good deeds. And there is another narration in which the Master of the Universe, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, has stated that if someone fasts on the 1st day of Rajab, then Allah Ta'ala forgives 60 years of his sins. And if someone fasts for 14 days, then on the day of judgment, his accounts will be made easy for him. And whoever fasts for all 30 days of the month, then Allah Ta'ala says that I am so happy with this person of mine that I will not punish him. Subhanallah. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hujjatul Islam, Imam Muhammad Ghazali rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, writes in Mukashafatul Qulub that Hazrat Sayyidina Anas radiyallahu anhu narrates that the Holy Prophet, the beloved Habib sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, said, whoever fasts for 3 days in the sacred months, then he'll receive the reward of 900 years of worship. Now, my dear Islamic brothers, as mentioned before, the four sacred months are Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hajj, Muharram, and Rajab. Now, if anyone fasts for 3 days in any one of these months, then he shall receive the reward for 900 years of worship. And if anyone fasts for 3 days in all four of the sacred months, then he'll receive the reward of 3,600 years of worship. My dear Islamic brothers, subhanAllah, these months hold much, much blessings. We should revere and honor these months and do good deeds in these months. My dear Islamic brothers, there's a beautiful incident which explains and which illustrates beautifully the status of a Muslim who fasts in the month of Rajab. Once, Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam walked and passed by a mountain. And the mountain seemed strange somehow. It was gleaming and shining, and light was emanating from this mountain. Hazrat Sayyidina Isa Ruhullah alayhi salam asked Allah Ta'ala to give the mountain the power of speech. And the mountain spoke, and it said, Ya Ruhullah, what is it that you desire? Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam replied, that tell me about your state. The mountain then stated and said, inside of me there resides a man. A man is living within me. Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam then asked Allah Ta'ala to show him this man. All of a sudden, the mountain split open and a saint appeared from within. And the saint, his face was shining like the bright moon. And the saint said that I am an ummati, I am from the nation of Hazrat Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. And I made dua and supplicated to Allah Azza wa Jal that keep me alive until the announcement of the final messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so that I can do his ziyarat, so that I can view his nutritious face, and so that I can be classed as one of his ummatis. The saint said, Alhamdulillahi Azza wa Jal, I have been in this mountain busy worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal for 600 years. Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam then asked Allah Azza wa Jalla, O Ya Allah Azza wa Jal, is there anyone on the face of the earth who in your court is more noble than this person? Allah Azza wa Jal then replied, O Isa alayhi salam, anyone from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who keeps just one fast in the month of Rajab is more noble to me than this person. SubhanAllah, my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, from this incident it is apparent that a Muslim who fasts in the month of Rajab, he holds a very high status in the court of Allah Almighty. Make intention that we fast in this month. My dear Islamic brothers, the 27th night of Rajab holds great blessings, and there is a lot of reward for the person who fasts on the 27th of Rajab. Hazrat Sayyidina Mawla Ali Karamallahu Ta'ala Wajhahu Al-Kareem narrates that the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever fasts on the 27th of Rajab Al-Murajab, Allah Ta'ala will grant him the reward of fasting for 1,000 years. SubhanAllah. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, the 27th night of Rajab al-Murajab, this was the night that our beloved and most beautiful Prophet Muhammad Mustafa Ahmad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam was granted the Mi'raj. And this is the night, the Mi'raj is the night journey. This is the journey which leaves the greatest human minds baffled and dumbfounded. And my dear Islamic brothers, the Mi'raj, the celestial journey, can be split up into three sections. The first part of this journey is known as the Safari Asra. And this section of the journey was from Masjid al-Haram in Makkah Sharif to Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. And the distance between Masjidul Haram and Masjid Al-Aqsa is a journey of approximately 1.5 months on horseback. The second part of this journey is known as the Safar Mi'raj. And this part of the journey is from Masjid Al-Aqsa up into the skies until the Sidratul Muntaha, the furthest lot tree. Now, dear Islamic brothers, the distance between the earth and the first sky is equivalent to the distance covered by a horse if it was to run at full speed for 500 years. So you can imagine how great this distance is, up and beyond the Sidratul Muntaha. The third part of the journey, my dear Islamic brothers, is known as the I'raj. And this is from the Sidratul Muntaha, this part of the journey is from the Sidratul Muntaha to above and beyond. And it is said that the total Mi'raj is a journey of about 80,000 years. And all this distance has been covered by our beloved Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in just a few moments, in a very small portion of the night. My dear Islamic brothers, on the 27th of Rajab, in the last part of the night, when the moon had disappeared and everyone was busy sleeping, at that time the heavens were being decorated and the skies and the arsh were growing restless, because soon they'd get a chance to kiss the blessed feet of the beloved of Allah Ta'ala wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, in this final part of the night, Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam, along with a parade of 50,000 angels, arrive at the house of Hazrat Sayyidatuna Umm Hani binti Abi Talib. And this is where the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was staying. The Master of the Universe sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was given the clothes of paradise to wear and was also presented with the buraq. And the buraq is a creation, and the buraq is a creature of paradise. It is bigger than a donkey but smaller than a horse. And it is so swift that in one step it can travel to as far as the eye can see. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, along with the buraq and being surrounded by angels, set off on their journey. And within moments, this rafila reaches Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem. Here, they find every single Prophet alayhi wasalam ready for namaz, waiting for them. Hazrat Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam performs the azan, and Sayyidul Anbiya, the leader of the Prophets, the beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam, in salah. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated, thumma urija bi, then I was taken up. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken towards the skies. And within moments, they reached the first sky. And here, they see a man sitting. And on both his left and right side, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw massive groups of people. And when this man looks to his right side, he is happy and smiles. But when he looks to his left, he starts to cry, he is saddened. Sayyiduna Jibreel alayhi salam explains that this is Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. And on his left and right are the souls of his children. They are the souls of all of mankind. On his right are the people of paradise, and on his left are the people of the hellfire. When he looks to the right, he smiles, and when he looks to the left, he cries. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then met with Hazrat Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. And then Sayyidul Anbiya sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was taken up to the second sky. Here they met with Hazrat Sayyidina Yahya alayhi salam and Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. After this, they were taken up to the third sky. Here, they met with Hazrat Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. And then, they were taken to the fourth sky, where they met with Hazrat Sayyidina Idris alayhi salam. And they kept going higher and higher and higher. And on each sky, they met with a different prophet. On the fifth sky, they met with Hazrat Sayyidina Harun alayhi salam. On the sixth sky, they met with Hazrat Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, and on the seventh sky, they met with Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam. Now during this journey, my dear Islamic brothers, Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam was shown many strange and wonderful things. They were shown paradise, and in it they saw pillars made of pearls, and the sun was made of musk. They were also shown the hellfire and its punishments. They saw people eating burning hot stones, and these were those people who did not give zakat. They also saw a man who was diving into a river of flowing fire, and he was also eating stones. This man was one who dealt with riba, with interest. Now during the journey, Huzur alayhi salatu wasalam reached a vast flat plain, and here they say that they heard the noise of the qalam, the divine pen of destiny, writing. They heard the scratching of this noise. So they carried on journeying and going higher and higher. Eventually they reached the Sidratul Muntaha. The Sidratul Muntaha was the limit for Hazrat Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, because he could not go beyond this point. To go forth was only for our beloved Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Beyond this point, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to such a place where place itself does not exist. They went to such a place where time and space does not exist. They were at a place where seconds and minutes do not pass. They were there where there was no direction. The climax of the Mi'raj was when the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with his physical eyes, saw the beauteous vision of Allah azza wa jal. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the gift of namaz by Allah azza wa jal. Now other than this, my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, what was given, what was taken, what was said, what was heard, nobody knows. This is all a secret between the lover and the beloved. Even the Holy Quran does not disclose the secret to us. In Surah Al-Najm verse 10, Allah Azza wa Jal says, and He revealed to His servant what He revealed. My dear Islamic brothers, this was a very brief summary of the incident of the Mi'raj. We have summarized a journey of approximately 80,000 years in just a few minutes. But Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, we see the excellences of the 27th of Rajab al-Murajab, and we should all try to fast on this day. If anyone fasts on the 27th of Rajab al-Murajab, then if he dies that year, that person shall die as a shaheed. And my dear Islamic brothers, we have heard about the excellences of worshipping, the excellences of respecting this month, the excellences of fasting in this month, and also about the brief waqia of Mi'raj. Make intention, my dear Islamic brothers, to increase your namaz in this month, to increase your voluntary worship in this month, to increase your recitation of the Holy Quran, to increase your fasting. Try, my dear Islamic brothers, to fast in this month. This is, my dear Islamic brothers, the message of Dawat Islami. My dear Islamic brothers, try to travel in the Madani qafilas of Dawat Islami in this month. Allah Azza wa Jal give us the tawfiq to act upon what I have said. Ameen bijahin nabiyil ameen wa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Please send us your views and ideas regarding the program which you have just viewed to the following email address, feedback@madanichannel.tv, or text to the following numbers 03012612176 and 03124921389.